Hello everyone. Hi. Hope you guys can see me and hear me. Am I audible? Can you guys see me? Please just type a yes or a hello or okay so that I know you are there. Hi Adil. Hi Nan. Hi Rankit. Good to see you guys here. I hope I am visible and audible fairly clearly. Good evening. Good evening guys. Welcome, welcome Adil, welcome Nan, good to see you guys here. Well guys, the agenda for today's class. Is primarily to discuss boats and streams. Now this is a reasonably popular topic when it comes to time, speed and distance. We have been covering time, speed and distance for the past few days. Week also, and this is just continuing in that series. Now, for those of you who might be joining us for the first time, my name is Ravi Handa. I have been teaching for CAT for close to 15 years now, and I've taught 20,000 plus students online via my own website. Recently, I started taking classes on Unacademy as well. As a part of Unacademy, I'm taking classes on YouTube, special classes which are free classes on the platform, and the paid courses. So these are the broad areas that I cover. Now, as far as YouTube is concerned, I'm taking classes in the morning and in the evening. The morning classes are at 10 and 12. The evening classes are at 5 and 7. In the morning classes, I end up covering number system. And in the evening classes, I'm covering time, speed, distance. The special classes are the free classes which happen on the platform. For example, this Saturday at 7 p.m. I'll be conducting a quiz related to business awareness on the platform. The paid classes are the paid courses. I have, where did it go? Yeah. So on 9th of June, a paid course of mine is starting. In this course, I've divided my course into two categories. One is an intro course and the other one is a complete course. The intro course is a 4-class based course, which will be based mostly on puzzles. Now, puzzles, as you might know, form the foundation block for complete logical reasoning, which is what I'll be covering next in this particular batch. In case you're planning to prepare for CAT, and this, I believe, I should be able to finish by mid-July. By mid-July, I should be able to wrap it up. So in case you're planning to prepare for CAT and you're just starting, I'll strongly recommend to join this complete course on logical reasoning. It'll not only help you prepare, but do well in the exam. Well, and if you are planning to join, there are two kinds of courses which are available. One is the plus courses, the other one is the iconic courses. In the plus courses, you get live classes, much like this one, but they are in a structured format. That is, you do this, then this topic, then that topic. The entire course is structured that way. And then there are the iconic ones. In the iconic classes, you get these courses. Along with that, you get personalized guidance as well as to how you should plan your preparation and stuff like that. As far as the course prices are concerned, my recommendation to you would be to try out the 6-month plan, which is roughly for 16K, but you can get a discount on that if you use the coupon code HANDA. The price will come down by 10%. The reason for recommending the 6-month plan is because with the 6-month plan, you get an additional 1 month for free. And with this additional 1 month, your course will be valid roughly till the SAT exam. That's the reason why, I'm pushing for this. Hi, Atin. Good to see you here. Now, if you guys are ready, if you guys are good to go, I can start off with today's session. Please type a yes or an okay or something if you guys are ready and good to go with this. I am online throughout the session on chat on the YouTube app. So if you have any questions, any doubts, anything that you want to ask or discuss, you can use this whenever you want. So, first of all, what exactly are some of the terms? So upstream, what does upstream mean? Upstream means that if the river flow is in this direction, you are going in the opposite direction. So if you are moving against the flow, then you are known as an upstream driver or an upstream rider. Now the concept of upstream will come in case of river flows. That's a common category. Another case is, suppose you are driving a bike. Suppose you are driving a bike and wind is blowing. Now, if you are driving in the direction that the wind is blowing, then it is not upstream. But if you are driving opposite of the direction in which the wind is blowing, then you are riding upstream. Basically, there is movement which is hindering you in some way, which is stopping you in some way. And because of that hindering, it is known as you are going upstream or opposite of the direction of the flow. So very similarly, if that is upstream, what will be downstream? You can visualize from this, downstream would be exactly the opposite of it. That is, if you move along in the direction of the flow of the stream. So the direction in which you are going, in downstream, the direction in which you are going, you are going downstream, means that the river is also flowing in this direction, or the bike that you are driving, the bike is also going in that direction. And similarly, that is effectively how it works. The concept of downstream and upstream, let me see if some empty space. Yeah. So the concept of downstream and upstream can also be used in case of escalators. In case of escalators, because see, what happens is, suppose this is your escalator. Now, an escalator could be going up, and on the escalator, you could be going up as well. So, this is downstream when both are up. Very similarly, you are coming down, the escalator is also coming down. So, this is downstream while going down. This was downstream while going up. The reverse case is also possible, where the escalator is going up but you are running down on it. When the escalator is going up but you are running down on it, so this means you are going upstream, opposite with the flow of the river, opposite with the flow of the motion, while coming down. You are going upstream while coming down. And the final case is when you are going up, but the escalator is coming down. In this case, you are going upstream. Are you guys okay with these various nomenclatures? Downstream up, downstream down, upstream up. Because these are the more confusing ones. With the river, it's just upstream or downstream. Because the flow of the river is in a constant direction. The flow of the river is in a constant direction. That doesn't change anyway. Okay. With that being said, now, the most common questions in this, suppose the speed of the boat is A and the speed of the river is B. When you are going upstream, your effective speed will be A minus B, and when you are going downstream, your effective speed will be A plus B. Why does it happen that way? What's the logic behind that? See guys, what happens is, when you have a boat, now suppose if the water was still water, in 1 hour, you would have gone ahead by a kilometer. Now, if the, if the boat was not moving, on its own, then with the water flow, it would have gone ahead by b kilometer. So, effectively, in 1 hour, what will happen? Effectively, in 1 hour, it will go ahead by a plus b kilometer while going downstream. Let me see if I can find some empty space to clarify that as well. Suppose this is my river. This is my boat. Now my boat is static, boat is not moving. But the river is moving in this direction with the speed of r. So in 1 hour, the boat will not stay here. The boat with the water flow would have moved ahead. How much distance the boat will move ahead? It will move ahead r. Now imagine the case when suppose you are in a swimming pool of sorts. Now when you are in a swimming pool and then there is a boat, the boat will stay there, it will not move. If the boat is moving in this direction with A in 1 hour, so in 1 hour the boat would have covered A kilometers. Now when you are moving in the same direction as the river, A kilometer you will move on your own, R kilometer is what the water will push you. So your effective distance, that you are going to move, that is going to be A plus R or A plus B. When downstream, when it is the opposite direction, it will be A minus B. Do you agree with that, Yatin, Sajan, Mayank? Okay. Let's have a look at the third case. When, you know, what sort of questions can be there? And if, let's say, someone asks you that what is the, questions that can be. Let me see if I have a question. So, upstream, downstream speeds, we know. Yeah. So, this is the first type of questions which are there. In this type, you will be given the speed of the boat and the stream. So, both the speeds are known. You need to calculate the time to go upstream or the time to go downstream. So, what do you guys think will be the answer for the first question? Speed of a motorboat is given to me. How will you find out this particular value? How will you find out this particular answer? Speed of a motorboat is that of the stream is 36:5. It is 36:5. The boat goes along with the stream in 5 hours and 10 minutes. How much time will it take to come back? How do you find this out? Basically, you are given speed of boat divided by the speed of river is given to me as 36:5. You are given that the boat along with the stream, so time taken downstream is 5 hours and 10 minutes or 5:1/6, which is 31:6 hours. That is what is given to me. So, how do you proceed with this? What do you calculate from here? How do you actually find this out? Yatin, Sajan, if you have any ideas, any suggestions, what will you do? How will you calculate this? Let me know. You can use the chat window. I am online via the YouTube chat app. So in case, you know, you have any questions, I will be happy to answer them. No options. Relative speed, no. Can you tell me, find speed of the boat upstream and the speed of the boat downstream? Okay. So, how can you find out speed of the boat upstream and how do you find out the speed of the boat downstream? What you do is, you assume the speed of the boat as 36K and river as 5K. So, upstream will be 36K minus 5K or 31K and speed downstream will be 36K plus 5K or 41K or 41K. So this means speed upstream by speed downstream, we know will be time downstream by time upstream. because speed is inversely proportional to time. Now, what values in this do I know? I know speed upstream is 31, speed down 31k, speed downstream is 41k, time taken downstream is 31 by 6 hours. Time taken downstream is 31 by 6 hours. Time taken upstream is what I need to find out. So what will that be? K and K cancels. 31 and 31 cancels. Time taken upstream will be 41 by 6 hours, which is 5 by 6 hours. Sorry, 6, 5 by 6 hours. Are you guys okay with this value? 6, 5 by 6 hours, which is 6 hours, 50 minutes. Sajan is right. Are you okay with this? Calculations that I made. Now, if you are okay with this, then I will suggest a shortcut. Suppose you have P by cube as 7 by 3. Then how much will be P plus Q by P minus Q? P plus Q by P minus Q? Can you tell me that? If you have P by Q as 7 by 3, then P plus Q by P minus Q will be how much? This is known as componendo and dividendo, which you might have studied, you know, in earlier classes. So that is 7 plus 3 by 7 minus 3 or 10 by 4 or 5 by 2. You could have applied this very same idea here. What is speed upstream? Speed upstream is speed boat plus speed of the river. What is downstream? Speed of boat minus speed of the river, and that is the ratio that you need. So that will be 36 plus 5 by 36 minus 5, which is 41 by 31. You could have gotten this directly. Sorry, I've reversed it. This is slight mistake. Speed upstream, speed of boat minus speed of the river, and speed of boat plus speed of the river. So that will be 36 minus 5 by 36 plus 5 or 31 by 41. A value you could have obtained directly from here. Are you okay with this? Use of componendo and dividendo in this case. Akash, Mayank, hope you guys are okay. So this is type 1. Another common type is when, you know, you are given these speeds and you need to find out the speed of still water in stream. Try this one out. You are given downstream and upstream speeds. Downstream and upstream speeds are given to you. And you are asked for the speed of the boat and speed of the river. That is boat in still water, boat in still water. How do you do that? Any quick ways? That's correct, Sajan. See, basically what you need to do is speed of the boat is speed downstream plus speed upstream divided by 2, and speed of the river is speed downstream minus speed upstream divided by 2. So that is 32 plus 28 divided by 2, which is 30. And this will be 32 minus 28 divided by 2, which is 4 by 2 or 2. So this is a set of formulas that you can remember. Why does it work? What is the logic behind that? That I can tell you. The logic behind it is very simple. Speed downstream is nothing else but speed of boat plus speed of the river. speed upstream is speed of boat minus speed of the river. Now, what happens when you add the two equations? When you add the two equations, speed of river cancels out. You're left with twice speed of boat is equal to speed downstream plus speed upstream, which gives me this formula. Speed of boat is downstream plus upstream by 2. Or what you can do is you can subtract. When you subtract, these will cancel out. You will be left with twice of speed of the river is speed downstream minus speed upstream, which will give me this formula. Are you guys okay? If the water is still, how can it move? If water is not still, we are asking speed of the boat in still water. So that is not this stream. You know, if you pick up this boat and you place it in still water, then what will be its speed? Then its speed will be 30. Right now, when it flows with the stream, its speed becomes 32. When it flows against the stream, it becomes 28. My question is, if the water was still, if the water was not moving, then what will it be its speed? In that case, it will come out as 30. Is that okay now, Mayank? Mayank, are you okay with these values? Okay. Next case. Boat takes 8 hours to cover a distance while traveling upstream. So, time taken upstream is 8 hours. While traveling downstream, it takes 6 hours. Time taken downstream is 6 hours. If the speed of the current is 4 km per hour, the speed of the river is 4 km per hour. What is the speed of the boat in still water? Let's say speed of the boat is x. Now, can you find out the value of x? Or how do you find out the value of x? What equation can you use? What logic can you use to find out the speed of the boat in still water? How do you do that? How do you calculate it? See, first find the speed of the boat in current. Correct. So, basically speed downstream divided by speed upstream. Speed is inversely proportional to time. So that will be time taken upstream by time taken downstream. And now you put in the values. Downstream speed will be boat plus river. So x plus 4. Upstream speed will be boat minus river. So x minus 4. Time taken upstream is 8 hours. Time taken downstream is 6 hours. So this is 4 by 3, which will give me 3x plus 12. Equal to 4x minus 16, or I get the value of x as 16 plus 12, 28 kilometers per hour. Sajan, good job finding out 28 kilometers per hour. Good job over there, Sajan. Others, are you okay with it? The values that we have obtained. Okay. Now, this is a formula for average speed. This is a formula for average speed. I don't want you to use this formula. Let me see if I have some empty space to calculate this out. Okay. I know if you attended one of the earlier classes, if you attended one of the earlier classes when we talked about average speed, if you go from A to B with the speed of S1 and if you come back with the speed of S2, what is the average speed? What is the average speed? Can you tell me? If you go with the speed of S1, you come back with the speed of S2. This is something that we discussed in one of the earlier classes. What will be the average speed in this case? S1 plus S2, that's absolutely correct. That's absolutely correct. Now, imagine you have a boat in a river. So, it flows in this direction. So, what will be your downstream speed? Speed of boat plus speed of the river. What will be your upstream speed? Speed of boat minus speed of the river. So, what will be your average speed? That'll be 2. Speed of boat plus speed of the river into speed of boat minus speed of the river by the sum. So that is speed of boat plus speed of river plus speed of boat minus speed of river. This gets cancelled. This gets cancelled. So what are you left with? You're left with twice of speed of boat plus speed of river into speed of boat minus speed of river divided by twice the speed of boat. This gets cancelled. You're left with speed of boat plus speed of river minus into speed of boat minus speed of river by speed of boat. If you notice this carefully, what is this? This is the downstream speed. What is this? This is the upstream speed. And what is it being divided by? Speed of the boat in still water. So that's a formula that you can use for average speed. That's another formula that you can use for average speed. Are you guys okay with this formula? Upstream speed, downstream speed, product is divided by the boat speed in still water. Are you guys okay with these values? Upstream speed, downstream speed, boat speed in still water. Okay. Let's check then. How will you find this one out? A boat while going downstream in a river covered a distance of 50 miles at an average of 60 miles per hour. While returning, because of water resistance, it took 1 hour and 15 minutes to cover the same distance. What is the average speed during the whole journey? Various ways to do this. Give me the answer with whatever way you want. You want to use the formula that we have just discussed? Good. You don't want to use that formula? Good. But I need the answer. So how do I do that? How do I get the answer? Any ideas, suggestions? How do I get the answer for this? What you do is, a boat while going downstream in a river covered 50 miles at an average speed of 60. While returning, because of water resistance, it took 1 hour 15 minutes. So first of all, how much time did it take for downstream? 50 miles at 60 miles per hour, it took 5 by 6 hours. Time taken upstream, 1 hour and 15 minutes. So that's 1 by 4 or 5 by 4 hours. Now, there are various ways of calculating average speed. Let me use different methods. Method 1, total distance by total time. Which is total distance is 50 plus 50, 100 divided by 5 by 6 to go and 5 by 4 to come back, which is, I think 5 can be taken common. So 20 by 1 by 6 plus 1 by 4, which is 20 by 5 by 12. 1 by 6 plus 1 by 4 is that. Into 4. So this comes out as 48 kilometers per hour. This is one way of doing it. The other way of doing it, at what speed did you go? You went at 60 kilometer per hour. At what speed did you come back? You covered 50 in 5 by 4 hours. So you came back at 40. So what will be your average speed? Your average speed will be 2 S1 S2 by S1 plus S2, which is 100. So this comes out as 48 kilometer per hour. Another one, speed downstream is 60, speed upstream is 40. So speed of the boat is downstream plus upstream by 2, which is 50. And then you use the formula for average speed that we have just learned. Use this formula: upstream speed 40, downstream speed 60, boat in still water 50. So use this, 6 into 4, 5, 8. So 6 into 8, 48 kilometers per hour. So guys, the idea is not to get 48 kilometers per hour. I'm sure you can get that. The idea is to get it by which method. You can use this method, you can use this method, or you can use this method. Doesn't matter. But you should be comfortable with all these methods. Are you okay with these values? Whichever one you want, try this one out. What will be your answer here? A person challenged himself to cross a small river and back. His speed of boat in still water is 3 km per hour. He calculated the speed of the river that day as 1 km per hour. Took him 30 minutes to cover the distance upstream than the downstream distance. And I'm asked for the speed of the width of the river. So you have speed of boat as 3, speed of river as 1. You are given that time taken upstream minus time taken downstream is 30 minutes or 0.5 hours. Now, what do you do with this? Time taken downstream, upstream is 0.5 hours. 1 kilometer is what Sergeant says. I think 3 and 1 and 4, 4 and half and 1. No, that is incorrect. Obviously, your Shobhna of options is jaldi banega. But please remember, in any of these classes, my goal is not to solve the question. My goal is to teach you the methods so that you become capable of solving these questions on your own. I will do it, man. Options will be fast. But point one is, what do you think? CAT will come with this question? No, not really. Variations will come. Exactly, kabhi ye question nahi aane wala hai. Answer dekhne ki bajaye nikla kaise us pe dhyan do. Any ideas? Any suggestion, Shobhna or Sajan? How will you solve this? See, what you are going to do is speed upstream or speed downstream ka ratio. Upstream will be 3 minus 1. Downstream will be 3 plus 1, which means 2 by 4 or 1 by 2. So, if speed 1 is to 2 ke ratio mein hai, so time taken 2 or 1 ke 2 is to 1 ke ratio mein hoga. So, time taken upstream माइनस टाइम टेकन डाउनस्ट्रीम 2:1 के रेशियो में लिया है 0.5, यानी कि टी है 0.5, टी अगर 0.5 है यानी कि उसको डाउनस्ट्रीम जाने में लगता है आधा घंटा, उसको अपस्ट्रीम जाने में लगता है एक घंटा। अब देख लो डिस्टेंस कितना है, या तो अपस्ट्रीम की स्पीड ले लो 2:1, या तुम डाउनस्ट्रीम की स्पीड ले लो 4:0.5, कोई सा भी ले लो, डिस्टेंस तो तुम्हारा वही 2 किलोमीटर ही आएगा। आर यू ओके विद दिस साजन? आया 2 किलोमीटर तुम्हारा, अपस्ट्रीम ले लो या डाउनस्ट्रीम ले लो। ओके साजन, गुड टू नो दैट। इसमें बताओ क्या करोगे, स्टिल वाटर में 7.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर स्पीड है, रिवर की स्पीड है 1.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर, टेक्स हिम 50 मिनट्स टू रो टू अ प्लेस एंड बैक। तो टाइम टेकन अपस्ट्रीम प्लस टाइम टेकन डाउनस्ट्रीम, ये है 50 मिनट्स। बहुत सिमिलर है यार पिछले वाले से, वहां पे क्या था, बोट रिवर गिवन था, अपस्ट्रीम माइनस डाउनस्ट्रीम गिवन था, यहां पे क्या है, बोट रिवर गिवन है और अपस्ट्रीम प्लस डाउनस्ट्रीम गिवन है। अब तो निकालो, ये तो बहुत ही सिंपल होना चाहिए कंसिडरिंग हमने पिछले वाला क्वेश्चन किया है, एकदम सिमिलर क्वेश्चन है, अब तो इसका आंसर निकलना ही चाहिए। बताओ क्या आंसर आएगा इसका, कैसे निकालोगे इसको, अब तो आसानी से आ जाना चाहिए ऑनेस्टली स्पीकिंग। वही लॉजिक लगाओ, स्पीड अपस्ट्रीम बाय स्पीड डाउनस्ट्रीम, अपस्ट्रीम होगी 7.5 माइनस 1.5, डाउनस्ट्रीम विल बी 7.5 प्लस 1.5, that is 6/9 or 2/3. So if the speeds are in the ratio of 2:3, the time taken will be in the ratio of 3:2. So this will be 3t plus 2t is 50, which means t is 10 or time taken upstream is 30 minutes, time taken downstream is 20 minutes. Now you can use that. What will be the distance? Upstream ki speed is 6 kilometers per hour and it takes half an hour, so 6 into 0.5, or the downstream speed is 9 and time taken is 20 minutes or 0.333 hours. So overall my distance will come out as 3 kilometers. Are you okay with this value? The distance coming out as 3 kilometers? Sajan, Shobhna, are you guys okay with these values? Okay, Yatin, let's go ahead. So, let's do this series of 6 questions. It's the same data. I just want to take this to ensure that everyone has clarity on what needs to be done. Just to ensure that everyone has clarity on what needs to be done. So, what do you think will be the answer here? Let's quickly try and find these out. He can row the boat at 20 km per hour in still water. So, speed of the boat is given to me as 20 km per hour. He travels from A to B 75 km down river in 3 hours. The time taken downstream is 3 hours. Distance covered is 75 kilometers. So I have to find out the speed of the river. Sajan says it's 5. What will be the speed downstream? Distance covered by time taken, which is 25 kilometers per hour. And what is the downstream speed? That is speed of boat plus speed of river. That is 25. So, 20 plus speed of river is 25, which means speed of river is 5 kilometer. or R. Are you guys okay with this? Speed of the boat, speed of the river is 5 kilo. Boat is 20 kilometer per hour, river is 5 kilometer per hour. How long will it take for Ravi to go back from B to A? What will be your answer for this one? Now Ravi needs to go back from B to A. What is the distance that needs to be covered? Still 75 kilometer. As of now, he was traveling downstream. So now he will travel upstream. Speed upstream will be speed of boat minus speed of the river. Speed of boat minus speed of the river, which is 20 kilometer per hour minus 5 kilometer per hour, which is 15 kilometers per hour. And that gives me time taken upstream as 75 by 15 or 5 hours. That's correct. Then Rakesh has an older boat. When going from A to B, he takes 5 hours. So if he has an older boat, what remains same and what changes? A to B, the distance was 75 kilometers, so that will still be 75 kilometers. The speed of the river was 5 kilometer per hour, so that will still be 5 kilometer per hour. What is different this time? Speed of boat of Rakesh will be different. I don't know how much that is. What I do know is, when going from A to B, he takes 5 hours. A to B is what? Downstream or? A to B is downstream. So now, time taken downstream for him is 5 hours. If time taken downstream for him is 5 hours, then speed downstream for him is 75 by 5 or 15 kilometer per hour, which is speed of his boat plus speed of river, that is 5. That means speed of Rakesh's boat is 10 kilometers per hour. Let me represent that by SB dash. Are you okay? With this being 10 kilometer per hour, how long will he take to return? He has to cover 75 kilometers. In return, his speed will be upstream. Which will be 10 minus 5. So this will be 75 by 5. Or he will take 15 hours to return. That's correct, Sajan. It will be 15 hours. Next one. Speed of Rakesh's boat in still water. We have already found that out as 10 kilometer per hour. Then, in the monsoon, the river doubles its speed. That means the new speed of river, is 10 kilometer per hour. Then, how long will Ravi take to come back? Ravi's speed of the boat was 20 kilometer per hour. So Ravi's speed is 20 kilometer per hour. So how much time will he take for the round trip? For the round trip, he needs to cover 75 kilometers. Downstream, his speed is 30. Upstream, his speed will be 10. So the time that he will take is 75 by 30 is how much? 2.5 plus 7.5. So he will take 10 hours for the return journey. And finally, in the monsoon, the river doubles speed. So same case. Speed of the river now is 10 kilometer per hour. How long will Rakesh take? So Rakesh's speed of the boat is also 10 kilometer per hour. So downstream, he will be able to cover by 75 by 10 plus 10 or 20, 75 by 10 plus 10 or 20, but on the reverse, his speed will be 0. See, he will row with the speed of 10, the water will push back him at 10, so he will just stand wherever he was standing. So he will never be able to come back. Are you okay with these values? Absolutely correct, Sajan. He will not be able to come back. Now, these are some of our top performers. If you work hard, you can join them here next year. Every Sunday, a scholarship test is conducted by an academy, and you can use the coupon code HANDA to unlock that test. And once you unlock that test, suppose you are a top performer, then you can get the entire 1 year subscription absolutely for free. So please try for that. Please try for that on Sunday at 12. Let's try another couple of a few more questions on the same idea, same concept. What do you think will be the answer here? Speed of boat in still water is 4.5 km per hour. Speed of the stream, that is speed of the river, is 2.5 km per hour. Find the total time required by the boat to travel down 28 kilometers and up 12 kilometers. So the distance downstream is 28. The distance upstream is 12 kilometers. And I'm supposed to find out the total time taken. So how do I do that? Any ideas, any suggestions? How do I find out these values for the total amount of time that he is going to take for something like this? How do I find that out? Total. So you think it will be 10 hours? Distance covered downstream by the speed downstream, that is 4.5 plus 2.5. Distance covered upstream is 12 kilometers. At a speed of 4.5 minus 2.5, which is 28 by 7 plus 12 by 2, and that is 4 plus 6 or 10 hours. That's it. Yatin is absolutely right. You get 10 hours for this. Another one. These are simple questions. Let me remind you, I'm doing just a couple or more simple questions. CAT level questions, difficult questions, what you can expect in the exam. We'll do it in the second class. The second class is at 7:30 p.m. today. 7:30 p.m. today, I believe another 30 minutes or so for those questions. But till then, what do you think will be the answer here? 18 kilometer downstream in 4 hours, 18 kilometer upstream in 12 hours, speed of the boat in still water and speed of the stream. So, boat downstream speed is 18 by 4, which is 4.5 kilometer per hour. Upstream speed 18 by 12, which is 1.5 kilometer per hour. The speed of the boat, 4.5 plus 1.5 divided by 2, and that is 6 by 2 or 3 kilometer per hour. And speed of the river, 4.5 minus 1.5 by 2, that is 3 by 2, that is 3 by 2 or 1.5 kilometer per hour. These will be the values, 3 and 1.5. Pretty straightforward stuff. One more. And let's take this as the last one for now. What do you guys think will be the answer here? We are given the speed of Prashant, or the speed of the boat, is 7.5. It takes him twice as long to row upstream has to row downstream. So time taken upstream by time taken downstream is 2:1. Let's say speed of the river is x. That's what you have to find out, speed of the stream. And even these questions should not take this long. These questions should not take this long. Simple, straightforward questions, straightforward answers. What do you get as the value here? What do you get as the value here? See, speed downstream will be 7.5 plus x. Speed upstream will be 7.5 minus x. Now, this ratio upstream by downstream will be speed downstream by speed upstream, because downstream speed will be higher. So this is 15 minus 2x is equal to 7.5 plus x. So 3x is 7.5, or I get the value of x as 2.5 kilometer per hour, which is option 1. Sajan got this right. I hope you guys, got this. The few questions which are remaining, the few questions which, as you can see, from CAT to the IIFT, then SNAP, all of these we will be covering in the next class. The next class, once again, just a reminder to you, is at 7:30, where we will be discussing some more practice questions. I will also try to pick up some questions on escalators. Some questions on escalators, because you can get a question on escalators in the exam as well. After class 12, there are a few exams like IPMAT, which allow you to get into the IIMs directly. If someone you know is preparing for that, you can tell them about this new course or the new batch, which is starting from the 19th of June. Unacademy also has an Ask a Doubt feature, where you can click a picture of a doubt, send it to us, either me or someone from our team will clarify that for you. And if you are planning to register for any of the courses, I would recommend that you use the coupon code HANDA. That will get you a 10% off. And if you have not done it till now, I request you to please like this video, to please subscribe to our channel. The more likes we get, the more subscribers we get, the more free classes we will be allowed to take. So if you want me to continue taking these classes, please don't forget to like this particular video. So that's it for now. I hope you will join me again at 7:30 p.m. when we will be discussing other ideas related to both sets stream. Thank you guys. That's pretty much it for today. Hope to see you at 7:30. Bye Sajan. Bye Om. Bye Adil. Bye Atin. Bye guys. Bye everyone.